Crossville Lions football 1997 preseason show featuring the Crossville High School band, cheerleaders, and football team.
Stevens, along with Mike Bobo, my broadcast partner, we're here at Crossville's Memorial Stadium for the 1997 Crossville High School preseason football show. We thank you for joining us. Mike, tell us, when can folks join us on TV each and every week?
I think it's going to be Tuesday at 5:30 p.m. and every Wednesday and Thursday morning at 10 a.m. So that way, you know, people working different shifts can catch the show, and of course everybody can't get out, and for the ones that can always catch a replay.
So we welcome everybody to, number one, come out to the stadium if you can, get you a good seat early, and if you can't, then you catch us on the replay. We're just about ready to introduce everybody, and just can't wait till the season gets started. How about you, Mike?
Let's play ball.
We'll return right after this.
Shirley Hood and the Hood family invite you to come by Crossville Exxon for quality K1 kerosene, propane, truck and farm diesel, and the finest gasoline by Exxon. Drinks, milk, bread, and snacks, where you always get a free 20-ounce fountain drink with purchase of 8 gallons or more. It's Crossville Exxon on Main Street in Crossville. When you're in need of body and paint repairs, stop by Wren's Body Shop, Highway 68 in Crossville. Wren's has complete frame and body repairs, from a small dent repair to major body and framework. At Wren's, no repair is too large to handle. Wren's Body Shop, your ICAR, ASA, and DuPont certified repair shop, featuring exclusively DuPont paint, the official paint of NASCAR. Wren's Body Shop, Highway 68 in Crossville.
Everyone, to the Crossville High School kickoff show here at the preseason. We're going to, at this time, introduce the band members and ask them to come up one at a time and tell who they are and what instrument they play and maybe how many years they've been in the bands. We'll ask them to come ahead at this time.
Hi, my name's Liba Orr. I'm a junior this year. I'm drum major and mallet soloist. I'm also the band reporter.
Hi, my name is Haven Elms. I'm a junior and I'm a majorette.
Hi, my name is Lindy White. I'm a freshman and I'm a majorette.
Hi, my name is Keisha Walker. I'm a junior and I'm a majorette.
Hi, my name is Carla Gaines. I'm a junior and color guard captain, and I also serve as band secretary.
Hi, my name is Amanda McCollum. I'm a senior and I'm in the color guard.
I'm Tasha Willoughby. I'm a senior and I'm in the color guard.
My name is Rebecca Oliver. I'm a sophomore and I'm in the color guard.
My name is Melissa Malone. I'm a sophomore and I'm in the color guard.
My name is Amanda Crowley. I'm a freshman and I'm in the color guard.
My name is Jessica Brandon. I'm a freshman and I'm in the color guard.
My name is Crystal Kaylee. I'm a freshman
and I'm in the color guard.
My name is Brooke Beard and I'm a freshman and I'm in the color guard.
My name is Elizabeth Whitworth. I'm a freshman this year, and I'm in the color guard.
My name is Melanie Malone. I'm in 7th grade, and I play the flute.
My name is Brooke Walsh. I'm in 7th grade, and I play the flute.
My name is Leslie Solomon. I'm in the 7th grade, and I play the flute.
Hi, my name is Samantha Davis. I play the flute.
Hi, I'm Amy Hawkins. I play the flute. I'm a junior and in the percussion pit.
Hi, my name is Lindsay Hackham. I'm a sophomore. I'm flute and clarinet section leader and assistant drum major.
Hi, my name is Katrina Fowler. I'm a freshman and I play the clarinet.
Hi, my name is Christine Livingston. I'm in 8th grade and I play the clarinet.
My name is Tonya Smith, and I'm a freshman, and I play the clarinet.
Hi, my name is Courtney Williams. I'm in the 7th grade, and I play the clarinet.
Hi, my name is Tiffany Howe. I'm in 7th grade, and I play the clarinet.
My name is Leah Simmons. I'm in 8th grade, and I play the clarinet.
Hi,
Hi, my name is Erica Brown, and I'm in 7th grade, and I play the clarinet.
Hi, my name is Toby Cason. I'm in 7th grade, and I play the saxophone.
Hi, my name is Suzanne Nims. I'm a sophomore, and I play alto saxophone.
My name is Alan Dawkins. I play an alto saxophone, been in the band for 3 years, and I'm in the 8th grade.
My name is Nellie Stevens. I'm in the 8th grade, and I play the saxophone.
My name is Carrie Hunt. I'm a junior. I'm a mellophone and saxophone section leader, mallet soloist, and I'll be serving as band captain.
My name is Danielle Herr, and I play mellophone. I'm in 8th grade.
My name is Monica McCollum. I'm a freshman, and I'm serving as trumpet section leader.
My name is Sean. I play the trumpet with Garrett.
I'm James Easterling. I'm in the 10th grade, and I play trumpet.
I'm Brandon Miller. I play the trumpet, and I'm a freshman.
My name is Amanda Easterling. I'm in 7th grade, and I play the trumpet.
My name is Sonia Crowley. I'm in 7th grade, and I play the trumpet.
Higgins, I'm a junior. I play the trombone, and I'm the low brass section leader.
My name is Stephanie Yeh. I'm a sophomore, and I play trombone.
My name is Bridget Kelly. I play trombone. I'm in 8th grade, and I play in the percussion pit.
Joshua Carlson. I'm in 8th grade, and I play the trombone.
I'm Gavin Wilkes, and I play the baritone.
I'm Joseph Williams. I'm in 7th grade, and I play the baritone.
I'm Andrew Gamblin. I'm in the 7th grade. I play tuba, and I'm also in the drum pit.
My name is Celeste Smith. I'm a sophomore, and I play snare.
My name is Michael Leith. I'm a senior, and I play quads, and I'm the percussion section leader.
My name is Keith Smith. I'm a freshman, and I play quads.
My name is Josh Whitworth. I'm in 7th grade, and I play bass.
My name is Blaine Cox. I'm in 9th grade, and I play bass drum.
My name is Ryan Hubbard. I'm in the 9th grade, and I play bass drum.
Hi, my name is Ashley Bearden, and I'm in the 6th grade, and I'm playing the role of Dorothy in the halftime show this year.
Hi, my name is Carrie Smith, and I'm in 6th grade, and I'm going to play the Scarecrow in the halftime show this year.
My name is Lauren DeBerry, and I'm in 6th grade, and I play the part of the Tin Man in the Banjo.
Hi, my name is Courtney Bolt, and I'm in 6th grade, and I'm going to play the part of the Cowardly Lion in the halftime show.
Hi, my name is Miranda Miller. I'm in the 6th grade, and I'm a majorette manager.
Hi, my name is Savannah Nairn, and I'm a flag manager.
Hi, my name is Marla Morris. I'm in 6th grade, and I'm a flag manager.
Hi, my name is April Gormley, and I'm in 6th grade, and I'm a flag manager.
Hi, my name is Chad Downer. I'm in 6th grade, and I'm a drum manager.
Hi, my name is Ben Bearden, and I'm in 3rd grade, and I'm a drum manager.
And we'll return in just a moment with more of the preseason show.
Beam built-in vacuum system for your home. Beam means more power to pick up deep down dirt on any surface, everywhere in your home. The all-steel heavy-duty power unit is mounted away from the living area, maintenance-free and guaranteed for a lifetime of trouble-free operation. Installs quickly and easily in any new or existing home. So why lug a vacuum? Plug in a Beam. Whether it be auto, home, farm, or life, call your Cotton States agent, Randall Gardner. He'll be happy to help you design a program specifically for you. Many discounts are available, along with a premium finance program to fit your budget. So if you have a need for any type of insurance, Call an agency that's served Sand Mountain for the past 25 years, Gardner Insurance Agency. They're conveniently located on Highway 431 South in Boaz, four doors down from Wendy's. Phone Boaz 593-7756 or the Crossville office 528-7196. That's Gardner Insurance Agency. Stapleton's Accounting Service on Main Street in Crossville. Stapleton specializes in business and personal accounts, bookkeeping, payroll preparation, financial statement preparations, audited financial statements, large and small business accounts. Come see Rodney Stapleton or Betty Holcomb, both certified public accountants. For your tax and financial services, remember Stapleton Accounting Service, 528-7060 in Crossville.
Memorial Stadium with more of the Crossville High School preseason football show. We're here with band director Mr. Bearden, and he's going to introduce to us now some of the extras in this year's halftime show. Some of the youngsters, the Munchkins, that's going to be in the show. We'll hand it over to Mr. Bearden and let him go ahead with the introductions.
Thank you, Morris. As you know, we are going to do the Wizard of Oz this year, and we have quite a few of these young folks who are going to help us out this year as Munchkins in our show. I'll call these out and they can come forward. First, Hillary Townsend. Hillary's in the fourth grade this year. Kelly Norris in fifth grade. Whitley Bankston. Willie's in the second. Adam Gamblin, third grade. Rachel Davis, fourth grade. Brittany Young, third grade. Rebecca Hubbard, third grade. Dava Terrell, third grade. Natasha Terrell, third grade. Courtney Neal, second grade. Allie Bobo, first grade. Shanna Thacker, first grade. Noelle Fant, third grade. Courtney Thacker, this is Lindsay Davis, third grade. Courtney Thacker, second grade. Lexi White, second grade. And Olivia DeBerry, second grade. These folks have all come out to help us with our show this year.
With us now, two of the band members who serve as leaders in the group, and we're going to just talk to them just a few moments. Tell us who you are and what do you do in the band?
Hi, my name is Luba Ower, and I'm the drum major this year.
My name is Carrie Hunt, and I'm band captain.
Carrie, being band captain, what's your role as being band captain? How important is that?
I think it's my responsibility to show leadership and to be someone that the younger ones can look up to and count on.
Do you ever have any unruly band members you have to get on to? Being band captain, you have to set the example and kind of discipline sometimes, don't you?
Yes, sir.
What kind of halftime show are we looking at this time?
We're going to do a show with the Wizard of Oz this year.
Tell us a little bit more about that. Some people are going to be thinking, Wizard of Oz, that sounds interesting, but what are they going to see when they come out?
We're going to have Munchkins this year and Dorothy and the Tin Man and the Scarecrow and the Lion. And just a lot of extra stuff.
All right. How much work has been put into putting on a show like that? How long does it take to put together a halftime show?
A lot of the upperclassmen work this summer in the band office and helping line off the field. Then we have 2 weeks of band camp and practice 4 days a week after school.
Ladies, we thank you much for spending a little time with us. We're going to ask three of the four seniors to come in also and share with us just a little bit. So we're going to ask them to come in at this time. These are three of the four seniors in the band this time. Tell us who you are and what part you play in the band.
My name is Michael Leith. I'm the percussion section leader, and I also serve as chaplain of the band.
I'm Amanda McCollum. I'm in the color guard.
I'm Tasha Willoughby. I'm in the color guard.
A little bit about your role in the band. Tell us why it's important for senior leadership. You're the seniors of this group. What part does that play?
Well, much like the band captain, we have to set an example for the younger kids because we tend to know a little more about the band than they do, and they usually come to us for advice.
All right. I know that being in a band is a lot of hard work. What have you gained from being in the band? You're a senior now. This is your last year in the band. What have you gained from your years being in the band?
The ability to work with others and playing an instrument. That's
about it. Have you had a lot of fun this going into your last year? You're seniors now. Is this year going to be a lot funner maybe than other years? Is the pressure more or great?
Well, it's kind of mixed because the pressure's kind of more because this will be our very last season, and we want to be the best one we have, but I think it's going to be probably the best one we have.
Can you tell us a little bit, what do you think you've gained from the band you can carry after you get out of high school? Any of you?
Well, hopefully, if we want to, and we're good enough, we can go on to college on a band scholarship.
Thank you much, and we look forward to a wonderful halftime show. Thank you all for spending time with us today. We'll return right after these messages.
Just a little kid. At Colonial, we believe banking is a lot like fishing. You have to know the waters. Know what really matters to all those big old fish. Most of all, you need a can-do spirit that just doesn't quit. If you have all that, you'll find the best doesn't always have to be the biggest. The best will just catch more fish. No matter where the road takes you, make sure your first stop is at the big blue Goodyear sign. Wilkes Tire and Battery, your source for Goodyear tires and the best service in town. Come to the big blue sign for tire know-how, service you can trust, and a nationwide warranty that's honored wherever you go. Wilkes Tire and Battery, Highway 431 and 75 in Albertville.
High school football preseason show. We're here with band director Mr. Ron Bearden. He's going to share with us a little bit about what goes into a halftime show. Mr. Bearden, we thank you for taking the time with us today. Tell us a little bit about this year's halftime program.
Well, Morris, this year we are going to do the Wizard of Oz. We like to do the theme shows, and this year we've chosen that as our theme. We've got a lot of the extras that we're going to try to put into the show that makes it entertaining for the audiences. We have introduced the Munchkins, and so we're going to use them in the show this year, in the characters. We've got some scenery that we're going to put in the show on the sidelines to try to make it as close to the Land of Oz as we possibly can.
Right. Every year it just seems like you keep coming up with these grander and grander ideas. Where do you get your ideas for halftime?
Well, we just kind of think about things, and we write down maybe in the early summer a list of themes or ideas that we may want to pursue, and we kind of check and see what kind of music is going to be available for the summer, for the coming fall season, and we talk about some ideas and some ways that we can possibly carry those ideas onto the field, and some possibilities that might exist or come up with some of the possibilities for ideas, and we kind of narrow the list down and eventually choose our theme.
Right. When you say you write down a list of possibilities, how much input does the band, the leaders of the band anyway, how much input do they have in choosing these?
Well, Libba has been a right hand to me this summer, and Lindsey Holcomb, our assistant drum major, has too. They've worked a lot this summer in the office just trying to get things ready for the fall. We sat down one morning and just wrote down themes, a lot of musical themes, Grease, and a lot of things like that we could come up with. And then we started kind of narrowing down our choices, and we took a few days and narrowed down until we finally came up with our theme. So I think it's important that the students are involved in the decision making, because if they're not happy with the show that they're doing, then they're not going to want to perform it well.
Right. I know with the addition of the children, the Munchkins in the program, you're going to have a larger band to be a feel full of them. How many are you going to feel this time?
Well, I think we've got 57 actual band students marching this year, and we've got all six or eight regular managers that will help out on the sidelines. We've got four kids playing character roles, and then we've got, I think, 17 munchkins. So I've not even added all that up. And then we'll have a good many parents. It's going to take several parents, not only on the front sideline this year, but also on the back sideline. We've got a few things from the back sideline that we're also going to do this year that we hope that we'll add some to the show.
I know every year, folks, when it comes to halftime, a lot of folks want to run concession stand, but here at Crossville, folks stay in their seats for a little while to see the halftime show, and that's a great credit to you and the band program, and we appreciate you taking time with us today.
Sure thing. I appreciate the audience. Crossville has always given us a good response, and I appreciate the community supporting our band. I'd especially like to thank my wife, Janet. She's put up with me the latter part of the summer, and all the hours that I've put up here, and she's put a lot up here too, and helping with the band, and also another teacher on our staff, Patsy Townsend, has helped a lot. There, Pat and my wife are both in the band room right now doing painting, and painting some of these scenes, and I like to express my gratitude to both of them for them helping out with this year's halftime show.
Thank you much. You've piqued our interest now for the halftime show, and we look forward to it. Hope you have a great season. Thank you much.
All right. Thank you, Morris.
We'll return right after these messages.
Shirley Hood and the Hood family invite you to come by Crossville Exxon for quality K1 kerosene, propane, truck and farm diesel, and the finest gasoline by Exxon. Drinks, milk, bread, and snacks, where you always get a free 20-ounce fountain drink with purchase of 8 gallons or more. It's Crossville Exxon on Main Street in Crossville. When you're in need of body and paint repairs, stop by Wren's Body Shop, Highway 68 in Crossville. Wren's has complete frame and body repairs, from a small dent repair to major body and framework. At Wren's, no repair is too large to handle. Wren's Body Shop, your ICAR, ASA, and DuPont certified repair shop, featuring exclusively DuPont paint, the official paint of NASCAR. Wren's Body Shop, Highway 68 in Crossville.
We're here with the Crossville High School Lions preseason football show. At this time, we want to introduce the 1997 cheerleading squad for here for Crossville, and we're going to just allow them to come up one by one, tell who they are, and how many years they've been serving.
Hi, my name is Lisa Kidd. I'm a sophomore, and I've been a varsity cheerleader for 1 year.
Hi, my name is Felicia Roden. I'm a sophomore, and I've been a varsity cheerleader for 1 year.
Hi, my name is Jessica Taylor. I'm a sophomore, and I've been a varsity cheerleader for 1 year.
Hi, my name is Tiffany Childress. I'm a junior, and I've been a varsity cheerleader for 2 years.
Hi, my name is Andy Frazier. I'm a junior, and I've been a varsity cheerleader for 2 years.
Hi, my name is Amber White. I'm a senior. I've been a varsity cheerleader for 1 year.
Hi, my name is Christy Holcomb. I'm a senior, and I've been a cheerleader for 3 years.
Hi, my name is Monica Pierce. I'm a senior, and I've been a cheerleader for 1 year.
Hi, my name is Heather Parker. I'm a senior. I've been a varsity cheerleader for 1 year.
Hi, my name is Heather Townsend. I'm a senior. I've been a cheerleader for 3 years.
We're going to ask Heather just to stand right here with us. She's one of the leaders in this band, and we're going to ask Andy if she would to come back. Join us right over here. Andy is head cheerleader and Heather is co-head, and just want to talk to them just a moment. Andy, tell us, where did you attend summer camp, and how did things go there?
We attended Jacksonville State University. We received second in our dance competition and second in our sideline competition. We also received numerous ribbons and a spirit stick each night. Christy Holcomb, which is one of our seniors this year, she made UCA All-Star, and she will be traveling to London, England this year, and we just want to wish her the best of luck.
Heather, what are you going to be doing different this year in your routines than what most people have seen from last year?
Well, this year at the pep rallies, we're going to try to begin people more involved by doing simpler cheers and maybe some spirit competitions between classes to get more people to stand up and yell with us. And at the games, if you want to see the cheerleaders get a workout during the games, Whenever our team scores, we're going to have to run down to the end zone and do push-ups for however many points our team has, so hopefully we'll be getting to do a lot of them.
All right, so we may see the cheerleaders with bigger arms than the football players. Andy, is there anything you want to share with the people, tell them about this year?
We just all want the fans to come out and help us to support our Lions this year, and that's it.
We thank y'all for coming and taking time and being with us, and wish everybody well, and ask Heather just to keep getting better, and we thank you much. We'll be back with more of the Crossville High School preseason show after these messages.
Trucks and More, Highway 68 East in Crossville. 24-hour wrecker service, towing and recovery, wrecker flatbed and heavy towing. And Dino's also carries a complete line of towing and truck accessories. Dino's now has express oil lube and brake service. Most vehicles $19.50. Oil change includes up to 5 quarts of your brand oil filter, lube, tires, pressure checked, wipers and fluid. And there's a clean, comfortable waiting area. That's Dino's Trucks and More, Highway 68 East, Crossville.
Preseason kickoff show. This time we're going to take a closer look at the 1997 football team, ask them to come up individually and tell a little bit about their position and who they are.
My name is Donnie Walker, freshman, tailback.
Tyler Harris, freshman, split end.
Robbie Coker, sophomore, split in.
Brett Hogan, sophomore, quarterback.
Matt Pointer, sophomore, tight end.
Tyler Bankson, sophomore, linebacker.
Adam Clark, sophomore, defensive tackle.
T.J. Henderson, sophomore, tailback.
Stephen Morland, junior, tailback.
Brad Bruce, junior, quarterback.
Zach Wallace, junior, outside linebacker.
Will Rogers, junior, guard.
Heath Davidson, junior, tight end.
Randy Vinsky, junior, split end.
Michael Banks, junior, defense tackle.
H.D. Nash, junior, guard.
Richard Bruce, junior, center.
B.J. Butler, junior, tackle.
Byron Fricks, junior, split in.
Jeremy Bright, junior, guard.
Curtis Renfro, junior, defensive tackle.
K.
Cody Sampson, senior, defensive back.
Derek Rogers, senior, defensive back.
Marty Hicks, junior, split in.
Michael Edmondson, senior, offensive tackle.
Sam Chandler, center, senior.
Luke Peake, senior, inside linebacker.
Tex Martin, senior, outside linebacker.
Blake Raley, senior, defensive end.
Patrick Cagle, senior, middle linebacker.
Todd Harper, senior, fullback.
Corey Garner, manager. Clay Allen, manager. Bart Rogers, manager.
And we'll return right after these messages as we introduce the seniors of this year's to talk with the senior leaders of this year's squad, and they're going to tell us who they are and how many years they've been serving.
Michael Edmondson, 1 year.
I'm Sam Chandler, and I've played 1 year.
Marty Hicks, 2 years.
Derek Rogers, 3 years.
Cody Sampson, 2 years.
Derek and Cody are going to serve as our spokesmen for this group and answer a few questions. Cody, if you could tell us a little bit about the senior leadership on this team and how important is that?
It's real important. We got a bunch of young people and some that hadn't got to play as much in the last few years. And we've had to come out here and inexperienced and everything. So we're going to try to pick them up and guide them through the year.
Derek, tell us a little bit about spring training. That's always a fun part of the football season, isn't it? How tough has it been?
It's been a little rough. I mean, it was early mornings coming up here for 4 hours of time. I mean, it's just basically running and lifting weights, but it's stuff we've done for 3 or 4 years. So, I mean, it really ain't much to us. But some of the younger guys, it's kind of hard for them to adjust.
Cody, you're one of the seniors this year. Have you had any underclassmen you've had to kind of chastise, kind of whip in line?
We hadn't had any of them this year. We've been pretty good with them. They've all come out here and run and everything. There's a couple of days we had to say something to them, but that's just a few.
This is the first group of our seniors. We're going to ask the second group to come up and talk with them in just a moment. Football team, and we'll talk with them at this time.
Blake Raley, 2 years.
Luke Peake, 3 years. Tex Martin, 3 years.
Patrick Cagle, 4 years.
Todd Harper, 4 years.
Patrick and Todd are going to serve as our spokesmen for this group. Todd, tell us a little bit about how important you think it is for seniors to be on this team.
It's important to show leadership, and I ain't show leadership as much as I should have, but that's kind of the running. As Derek was talking about, some of the smaller guys didn't think the running was bad, but some of us older and bigger guys thought it was pretty bad. But Coach Garman, he knows whatever's right, so we're just trying to get in shape for the season.
Pat, tell us a little bit about what do you think this team is going to be characterized by? Are you going to be a speedy team, a sizing team? Do you have a lot of depth?
How
do you
characterize this? We got a lot of heart, and we work real hard at what we're trying to do. And well, I guess we got a good bit of size, but our team speed this year ain't going to be what it was last year. But we've been working real hard to try to get faster and in shape. We can play some football and go out and hit a little bit.
Todd, one final question for this group. You've been going through spring training, a lot of summer activities, and now you're ready to get it on with the first game. Are you looking forward to hitting some competition instead of beating up on your teammates?
I've been looking forward to it ever since the last game last year. We're just ready to go out there and, you know, have a little fun. It ain't so much about winning or losing. Just a senior year, we want to have as much fun as we can with a winning record, you know.
We thank you guys for staying with us, and we'll return right after these messages.
Beam built-in vacuum system for your home. Beam means more power to pick up deep down dirt on any surface, everywhere in your home. The all-steel heavy-duty power unit is mounted away from the living area, maintenance-free and guaranteed for a lifetime of trouble-free operation. Installs quickly and easily in any new or existing home. So why lug a vacuum? Plug in a Beam.
Central Bank, call 593-0203.
coach of the Crossville Lions, Coach Garmin. Tried to get his insights on what he thinks this year's season is going to be like. Welcome, Coach. We thank you for spending a little time with us. One thing right off the bat, you're going to have a new face in your coaching staff this time, Tony Bright. What kind of addition is that going to bring? Is it going to change the character and makeup of this team?
Well, you know, yeah, it will. We lost a good one in Coach Bice. Been here about 5 years and a great, you know, great defense coordinator we had. You know, getting Coach Bright in is going to help us. He's from Crossville, and, you know, he knows the tradition that we've had here, and he'll be a big part. And also we got Coach Smith, Coach Danny Smith from Pisgah. He was the offensive coordinator up there, and we brought him in. So we lost Coach Bice, but we got two more. If they'll be as good as Coach Bice, you know, I'll be tickled to death.
Right. You got some returning players this year that are going to have to fill some big shoes from last year. You lost quite a bit in talent and in number. What kind of returning players have you got coming back?
Well, I think we got some quality, you know, players coming back. We just haven't got that many of them. Basically, we lost 14 seniors, which, you know, don't sound like a lot on a high school football team, but really, in reality, we lost 19 starters. We lost 14 seniors, and then we lost one eligibility. So, you know, we got a lot of shoes to fill, but the guys that we've got coming back, three on offense and basically two on defense, those five, we're going to depend heavily on them.
Right. Some of the guys have already talked about spring training, how rough it was during the summer and this. Have you had any injuries that's going to play a part, especially in the first game of the season?
Well, yeah. Just here recently, the last week or so, we've had probably more injuries than we've had since I've been here. And I can't figure out the cause of it. I don't know if we're just getting tired or whatever, but some reason we've had more injuries. A couple of them could be serious where they'll miss two or three games, and then again, they may not. But I think overall, to be as late as it is, we're probably, you know, healthy as we've been in a while.
Just a couple other questions. You lost some key players from last year's team that graduated, and some of them that went on and now are playing football at the next level.
Yeah.
Mikey Wade and Dusty Darnell and David Bowman, just to mention a few. Tell us a little bit, what do you know about them going on, and how sorely are they going to be missed?
Well, you know, them three right there were, you know, were really the backbone of our football team. Not that the others wasn't important, but, you know, we depended on them in so many ways. And they're gonna make good college players, and they're gonna make good people. They already are. It's hard to replace, you know, somebody like that. You know, they meant so much as far as leadership and you know, it's just like having three coaches out there on the field. And somebody you depend on. It's going to be tough to replace them. But, you know, we've got some young kids that stepped in, and we got kids that are not young. You know, we have some 11th and 12th graders, but they have no football experience. So, you know, it's basically like playing 9th and 10th graders. So it's going to be a struggle for a while.
The players have talked about they're ready to play some competition against some other folks instead of beating up on themselves. How does the coach feel about that? You ready to get the first game underway?
Yeah, I'm ready just to get there and see where we stand, how we compare to somebody else. You know, you get to a certain point in fall practice and summer practice where, you know, it gets to a what they call a lull there, where everything looks like it's going in slow motion, and that's where we are right now. And I hopefully next week or so, you know, we can get our legs under us and get ready to play.
First game Saturday night, September the 6th. You travel to Ider. What do you know about them?
I know that they'll be as physical as anybody will play all year. I know that Coach Wells will have them ready to play. They were a lot like us. They lost some key players. They didn't lose as many starters as we did, but they lost some very, very good football players, but they've also got some good ones coming back. So, you know, going to Ider, we'll have our hands full, and we'll be fortunate to come out on top.
Thank you for spending time with us today, and we look forward to a very successful season this year. Thank you much. We'll return right after this.
Whether it be auto, home, farm, or life, call your Cotton States agent, Randall Gardner. He'll be happy to help you design a program specifically for you. Many discounts are available along with a premium finance program to fit your budget. So if you have a need for any type of insurance, call an agency that's served Sand Mountain for the past 25 years, Gardner Insurance Agency. They're conveniently located on Highway 431 South in Boaz, four doors down from Wendy's. Phone Boaz 593-7756 or the Crossville office 528-7196.
That's Gardner Insurance Agency. Stapleton's Accounting Service on Main Street in Crossville. Stapleton specializes in business and personal accounts, bookkeeping, payroll preparation, financial statement preparations, audited financial statements, large and small business accounts. Come see Rodney Stapleton or Betty Holcomb, both certified public accountants. For your tax and financial services, remember Stapleton Accounting Service, 528-7060 in Crossville.
Of the Crossville High School football program ended in a successful regular season of 9-1 as the Crossville Lions went into the second round of the state playoffs. Mike, this time the football program could run upon some hard times. They could either be 0-3 after the first three games or 3-0, depending on how well they play, facing the likes of Ider and in Sylvania coming here and then having to travel to Geraldine. It doesn't get any easier.
No, it don't. And, you know, it's just it's kind of an uphill battle from the start, you know, and but I think the kids worked hard this summer, talking to Coach Garman and all. And, you know, I think it hard to carry them a long way, and it always does.
I know that injuries always plays a part. We talked with Coach Garman about some of the injuries. What do you know about some of them that may be a stumbling block right out of the gate for Crossville?
Well, just know what I hear is like what Coach Garman, you know, just talking to him in conversation. So, you know, there's some that we think should heal up and – you know, some we're not sure about, so we'll just have to wait just like everybody else will.
I know the expectations are real high for the community. This community here at Crossville has always expected a quality football program on the field, and nothing just says we can't have that again this year.
Yeah.
I just can't wait till Saturday night, September the 6th. I know they've been practicing, we've been preparing, and the community's been waiting, and just can't wait to get to Ider to finally see what kind of team we're going to field this year.
Well, you know, year in, year out, Morris, there have been some mighty fine teams come through here. And, you know, that's what the town of Crossville knows and what they expect every year. And the kids know that, and we know that. So, you know, I'm only looking for high, you know, expectations from all of them. And, you know, I think there's good things in the future.
And we encourage all of the fan support that Crossville's had for many years. Continue to support. Continue to come out. We look for a big crowd out at Ider. We've met the band members this afternoon. We've met the cheerleaders and the football team and coaches and things. And they're all ready to go, and we're just about ready to go.
It's time to rumble.
It sure is. We thank you for spending time with us. For Mike Bobo and all the Crossville 2 sports staff, I'm Maurice Stevens. We'll see you next week on the Crossville High School Lions football.